And once again, hang time. The elevation.
Kick back on goal. That's a magical snap from Ray DeMello.
He kicks towards the forward pocket. Mark's taken.
Good carry.
It has.
Hello and welcome to Amateur Footy Time, episode 17. Of course, I'm David McRae, and today I'm joined again by the lovely Frizz Ferguson, who's doing her best Adam McGrath impersonation today. And may I add, doing a much better Adam McGrath impersonation. Frizz, welcome back to Amateur Footy Time.
Thank you very much.
Of course, Frizz is the host of WAFL Wrap. Just around the corner are bitter enemies, but I'm sure she's very comfortable here in the surrounds of amateur footy. Frizz, fantastic weekend of footy. Some big upsets and, of course, some big upsets and big results in the context of finals places heading into the last round of the season. That said, I reckon we get into the fixtures. What do you reckon?
I reckon that sounds good.
All right, so we'll start off with the fixtures, which were round 17, of course, of the 2014 season, kicking off with league leaders Fremantle CBC taking on 20 Aquinas, and it was the league leaders coming out on top, 14-7-91, defeating the TA boys 10-5-65.
Yeah, so a 26-point win for Fremantle CBC. In saying that, though, Trinity Aquinas did really well to keep up with Fremantle and really have quite a competitive game there. So goals to Frio, Vincey had 5, which is fantastic, and Domenico 3. And for TA, Grierson had 4 and Crawford 2.
Yeah, more important win for a result for Rattea, obviously, because they're still battling for a finals place. Move on to the second fixture in that. Well, this was an upset. Well done here to Swan Athletic, 19-9-1-2-3, defeated West Coast 9-8-62, ending West Coast a bid for a slim finals chances, and what a fantastic win for the Swan boys.
Yeah, 61-point hiding there. And as you say, ending West Coast faint finals hopes and lifting Swan off the bottom there of the ladder.
Yeah, they were hoping we were down there a couple of weeks ago, hoping they had some drive towards the end of the season and come out with some positive, and that's a fantastic win from the boys up there in Swanland. The third fixture, Wesley Curtin, 23 goals, 20, wowee, 158, defeated, well, Whitford's, this is a bit of embarrassment, 2 goals, 3, 15. What an absolute flogging.
Yes, that was the largest margin of this season, 143 points between the two teams. 43 scoring shots to 5. It would have been a depressing day for the Warriors. Sees them take the bottom place on the ladder.
Yeah, that's a pretty disappointing result for the Warriors. Predicted that Wesley Curtin would probably come out and want to prove a point and build some percentage to retake that top spot, but wow, I don't think anyone could predict that. Well, let's move on because that's shocking. Kalamunda took on University, and it was the Cougar boys with, well, somewhat of an upset win. 14-4-88, defeated University 12-6-78.
Yeah, 10-point win there for Kalamunda, an important result in context of the finals places as well. Both sides had 18 scoring shots, so unfortunately University just missing out there. Results end Uni's bid to claim second place, and the goals for the Cougars include Morris with 3 and Holmes with 3 as well.
Let's have a look at the final fixture of the round. Of course, this was our game of the week, and what a cracking match this was. It was Mount Lawley heading up north to North Beach, and we actually thought the Hawks might be a bit competitive, but not this competitive. 15-9-99, upset win against the boys from the beach, 8 goals, 11-59.
Yeah, 40-point victory for the Hawks there. As you said, upset of the round and places the Tigers finals bids in major jeopardy. It was a tight contest for the first two quarters, 8 points to the Hawks at the main break, but the Hawks broke away in the third term with 6 goals. Their skipper, David McKinlay, was a strong performer, and their goals included 3 to McMicking, 3 to Dawson, 2 to McKinlay, Stephen had 2, and so did Forte. The Tigers' goals, Cranley had 3, Woolley 2, and Sajic 2.
Yep.
There. So the Tigers' coach, David Hines, was livid with his side, apparently.
Yeah, absolutely livid with his side. He kept the boys locked in the rooms after the game for a very, very long time. In fact, by the time we left, they were still in there. And he gave them a pretty big rev up too at three-quarter time. Just questioning, I guess, their commitment to the contest. Of course, we'll have a look at some of the interviews. We caught up with the gallant skipper for the Hawks, David McKinlay, and we had a chat to the North Beach assistant coach, Craig Dalton, as well after the game. But before we do that, we might actually just have a listen to that rev up that David Hines, of course, premiership player with West Coast Eagles in 94, that rev up that he gave his charges at three-quarter time to try and get them back into the game.
Standing the man on the mark, and you look around, you know that Bowie and the rest of the boys are taking all their loose players like this, so he doesn't have those easy options. You got to trust that your teammate ain't walking around like this, sucking his thumb because he's, you know, not feeling pretty good about how often not my day. So, one thing you can do, regardless of the result, is you can throw the kitchen sink at this quarter, and you can show your character. Right? And you can show the character in the colours you're wearing, the footy club, and you as an individual football team. Alright, let's go.
Mt Lawley captain Dave McKinlay here, mate, and a few changes to the side this week. Did you see that performance coming?
No, I think probably we spoke before the game about sort of like the shackles being off a bit and just to run and play some exciting footy, and we had a few changes, you know, forced changes through injury, and you know, we had a few young guys come in, they really stepped up, so it was really good.
Okay, we're here with North Beach assistant coach Craig Dalton. Craig, I guess did that result take you by surprise a little bit today?
Yeah, I think it took the coaches by surprise. The boys were really really up before the game, and we're looking forward to the challenge, and you know, good step towards the finals, but we don't quite know what's going on at the moment, so I think they're having a bit of a heart-to-heart in there and see if they can get the bottom of it. And we're still technically a chance to make finals, depending on results, so we need to get ourselves back up and ready for next week.
Well, that was Craig Dalton, assistant coach for North Beach Frizz, and we saw there that even he was pretty shell-shocked and disappointed with that result for the Tigers, because, of course, that puts pressure on them to try and break into the finals in the last round. Let's have a look at where the Tigers sit and the rest of the league after 17 rounds. And here's a ladder coming up on the screen now. And as we'll see there, Frizz, only two sides actually remained in the same spots from round 16. Frio CBC and North Beach, despite that loss, those two sides actually didn't move.
Yeah, that's right. So as you say, Fremantle CBC, they're clear on top with three games separating them behind on top of Wesley Curtin. So Wesley Curtin University swapped Kalamunda and Trinity Aquinas. They also switched around on the ladder there. As you say, North Beach kept their position. Mt Lawley and West Coast, they did the swapperoo, and so did Swan Athletic and Whitford.
Strange round, isn't it?
Strange, it's
round
very for strange. Positions. So after 17 rounds, Dave, that's where it's at. But where are your predictions looking now?
Well, everyone kind of knew my predictions a couple of weeks ago. Some of them were fairly controversial. I know viewers out there, and Adam McGrath, you know, he's drilled me for this. I have got one wrong. Thank you very much, Wesley Curtin. And for CBC, of course, they couldn't take out that victory there. Thank you, Lockie Dennis, for missing that goal. But yeah, so obviously those two positions aren't gonna come out from my prediction. But the five, I still reckon the five is pretty much going to be this as what I predicted a couple of weeks ago. Here's what I predicted. We'll have a flash this up on the screen, as you see there. Yep, as you say, I did get that one wrong at the top. Was the Curtin and Frio CBC. Only 4 points in it, thank you very much. I reckon we'll get into results or the fixtures for the next round. But that was the five I predicted. Where's the Curtin, Frio CBC, Uni, Kalamunda and North Beach, as we saw the ladder. Currently, North Beach still sitting outside the five, but I reckon this coming round with the results, I reckon they're going to break in. This is what I reckon the ladder will look like. I'm doing this again. I'm putting it out there. After this round, here it is on the screen now. And, yep, you see Frio CBC on top there. But North Beach, I reckon, is going to move into the five. TA's going to drop to sixth, and I know the team down at TA is probably chomping at the bit. They're great blokes, and we love going down there, and they love us coming down there, and I reckon they're getting some expletives ready for when they prove me wrong, but I still think that is potentially going to be the end result after this weekend, Frizz. What do you reckon?
Bite your tongue.
Yeah.
Bite your tongue there.
Well, with any bold prediction, you've got to back it up. So let's have a look at the fixtures for the very last round, in round 18 of the 2014 season. And we'll start with probably the most important fixture of the round, especially when it comes to my predictions, and that's TA taking on Kalamunda Frizz.
Yeah, so this one's Trinity Aquinas are fifth. They're sitting 9-8, and Kalamunda are only four. So a win would change the ladder around there. The winner will secure fourth spot, and the loser may drop to six, depending on their results.
So the next fixture at West Coast, taking on Mt Lawley in what will be a good contest, but in the scheme of things, a dead rubber, really.
Yeah, that's right. It's eighth versus seventh. The Hawks would need a monumental win and would have to rely on other results to sneak into the five. So I don't think that one's going to happen.
Yeah, they'll need to win by, well, I calculated 200 plus points to have any chance of breaking into the five, and then hope that other results go their way. And I've been saying for a couple of weeks that the Hawks wouldn't make the finals. Sorry, guys, you're probably going to miss out on percentage. Let's have a look at fixture number three, North Beach taking on Whitfords. And I tell you what, I reckon David Hines, he would have really put a rocket up his charges on the track this week. And poor old Whitfords in 10th spot might be in for another hammering.
Yeah, so the Beach could end, or should end, Whitford's disappointing season with a solid victory there, and see some movements in the ladder again.
Yeah, I think with percentage on the line too, that might be front of mind as the Beach boys run out onto the grass on Saturday. Let's have a look at, well, this is another big fixture, huge clash. Not going to be much for the ladder, but I tell you what, when it comes to finals, this result will be telling. Wesley Curtin taking on Frio CBC, a replay of the game a couple of weeks ago that was only 4 points in it, Frizz, and of course cost me my prediction.
There you go. So it should be a really close one here. You backed the Tigers the last round, and they had their chances and probably should have beaten Frio if it wasn't for wayward kicking. At home, they should get the job done, but it should be a really competitive game there.
Yeah, it should be another tight contest. But yeah, I'm going to back them in again. Hopefully they can kick straight. As you saw on the game of the week a couple of weeks ago, they had the better chances in the last term, and I'm sure that'll be front of mind as they head into this clash with the winner to, I guess, take an advantage into the finals, Frizz.
That's right.
Let's have a look at the final game of the home and away fixture for 2014, and that will be University taking on the Swan Athletic. Again, not much in it for either of these two sides, but for University, I guess it's a chance to build some momentum heading into finals, and for Swan to finish off the season on a high.
Yeah, this one's going to be a tough one for Swan Athletic. They have had some really good moments throughout the season, but I don't think this is going to be one of them. University sit third on the ladder, and Swan Athletic on ninth.
Yeah, I think they'll finish in that spot, which is good for them because they've got some sort of positive dragging themselves off the bottom of the ladder. But I think University will, after that loss last weekend, will probably want to put a side to the sword, and this week it happens to be Swan. So good luck to all the sides heading on out onto the grass this weekend, and I hope the results go your way, and I hope they will match my predictions as well. Let's have a look at the final match of the round for the home and away fixture, Frizz. And we said last week, we said it was such a round of such potential that we really didn't know where to go. So we put it out there to viewer land a couple of weeks ago, and we said, let us know where you want us to go for the final match of the home and away season in 2014. We said vote, and those with the most votes, that's where we'd go. So let's have a look at the results. This is what happened, and there they are. Have a look at that. A huge margin there. 58% said Wesley Curtin and Frio CBC. So that's where we're heading this week. Wesley Curtin and Frio CBC is the match around, and let's be honest, Frizz, it probably, even though it's not going to have any kind of context on the ladder positions, it probably is the match of the round. And another potential preview for finals coming in a week or two's time.
Yeah.
So big round of footy, Frizz, coming up.
Yeah, should be good viewer's choice.
Yeah, fantastic. Viewer's choice. Yeah, you can't press red, but, you know, just as good. Thank you to everyone that voted. We actually had a huge amount of votes, so thank you very much to all those who jumped on Facebook and tweeted, etc. So well done there. That's a wrap, I think. It's the final preview AFT episode for 2014. And of course, we are back for finals. We'll be doing it all the way through to grand final. So continue to join us for the finals. But what a fantastic season of amateur footy it's been. It's been probably one of the closest seasons for a very, very long time.
Yeah, great competition. Fantastic.
Thank you, Frizz, for joining us. I'm sure that viewers much appreciate, they did appreciate you joining us last time. They made lots of comments. They said Adam McGrath had done some fantastic things with his hair. So, again, thank you very much for joining us. I'm sure Mr. McGrath will be back again next weekend. But, yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
And we'll see you again out there in AFT and amateur footy land next weekend.